and it got to the second level. And what I mean by that is that's where the linebackers usually play, first level being the defensive front, last level being the secondary. But the strong safety. Position end up making the tackle, and oftentimes we call them a hybrid combination defensive back, combination linebacker. We saw the linebacker make the stop.
Long drive, the defense just cannot seem to catch a break and get off the field. Here's Peterson, and he'll fight his way down inside the 10 to the 9 yard line. The New York set to take the field. And what is going on here? Are they serious? First down, and they're in punt formation. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. And this will be down by a member of the kicking team just outside of the 30-yard line. The Giants defense now ready as they trot back out onto the field. And a big reason they've got the lead here in the second half, they have been swarming to the football and laying some big hits.
Yes, this is not the woodwinds or the string section at all in the band, is it? Straight percussion, and you can feel the thumps all the way up here, doing a great job putting themselves in the right spot to make those types of plays.
We got a chance to see some of those thumps. They'll come out throwing here on first down. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. Give him 8 on the play, and that'll make this a second down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
So it's Redskin football here as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. They'll look to throw. This is caught. It's Ryan Brand. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. And the offense moving quickly to the line. Back to throw. And incomplete. Out of the backfield, Adrian Peterson was the intended target. And that'll bring up second down. Scrimmage, but no more than that. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. He'll look to throw, finding time. And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Intercepted. Picked off by Akeem Ayers.
Well, they needed the touchdown and the two-point conversion, but they're not going to get a shot at either. This is a great play here defensively, Brandon, and at a time that they sorely needed one. And that could be enough to help get them out of here with a victory.
And he did get it back, I do think. Yes, so no turnover on the punt, and it'll be a first down. Out comes Washington's offense as they get set to take over here. They're down here in a one-score game, but the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences. And this is what they work on every week in practice, usually on a Friday. They go over this type of a situation, late game situation. What are we going to do when we have the opportunity? They've called these plays a bunch of times. Now's their chance to execute them.
Yeah, they have the opportunity now. Here's the execution. Offense trying to avoid stalling out, facing a third and 10. He's back to throw. He's got time. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
Everything looked right on that play except the conclusion. He dropped it, an in route, going into a little bit of traffic. Maybe in the back of his mind, he was wondering where the hit was going to come from.
Got to try it here. He's back to throw. And no, it's incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And that'll be just about all she wrote for this one. A gutsy decision there at this stage in the second half in their own territory. And a decision. That they might regret.
Can't wait for the post-mortem. You know, this post-game press conference, because the questions are going to come fast and furious about this decision, no matter how the game turns out, right? What were you thinking there? Why did you have a certain play?
The Redskins offense now, they head back onto the field. And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over. Good job by their defense, though. They held them to three, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on fourth down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than three. And that's exactly what happened.
You think
there.
That factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game, that I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a defense that can hold up their end.
And, Charles, in this situation, this is where the word miracle comes into play.
Have to score real fast, maybe throw a jump ball in the end zone and hope for the best.
Now McCoy. Too much juice. It'll be out of bounds, incomplete. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it.
Check, green, 39.
Here's McCoy. A hit as he throws, and this is going to be incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and that's going to be just about all she wrote for this one. And what is this? They're lining up here to punt on first down. And New York set to take the field. And last time, able to get three. It's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. It's a gain of five, and it'll be second down. And quickly, they get to the line. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And this one is incomplete. So incomplete on second down. Now they'll look to convert here on third.
Hurry up, here we go. Green, 39. Green.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And Wilson has it. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. On first down, he'll drop to throw. And almost intercepted. It would have been his second pick of the game. Instead, it'll be second down. Second down now after the incompletion. They'll look to throw again. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. It's the first round pick, Eli Apple with it.
Tremendous play right there by Eli Apple, sealing the game with that interception for his team. I bet that'll make his mom, Annie, really happy.
Absolutely making Annie proud. He was born in Philadelphia, tough kid from the city of brotherly love, and a tough play there to seal it. So it's an empty possession, and as a kicker, not the way you want to start your day's work.
And now each team's missed a field goal here so far, Brandon, so apparently neither guy is immune.
One final shot. They'll look to throw, and that will be incomplete as time has run out. Time it will host Super Bowl 52. You get a look inside the impressive new U.S. Bank Stadium in Minneapolis. Tonight, we finish off week four with a good Monday night matchup between the New York Giants and the Minnesota Vikings. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. Latavius Murray, and he is going to lose yardage here. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Well, on that play, the expression, don't blink, you might miss something, certainly applied. That was fast. Defense diagnosed the play, and it was over in a heartbeat.
To throw, Cousins. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. He was looking for Adam Thielen there, and that takes us from second to third down. Third and long for Cousins. And this is going to be incomplete. Latavius Murray, the intended receiver, out. First down. Looking for his tight end, Rudolph, and it's intercepted. Room here to run. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six and a Giants touchdown. I don't know who all is to blame there, but I love seeing pick sixes.
Nothing like seeing someone pluck it out of the air and go the other way and see people try to change directions. Hard to do.